9th class children, how are you? Okay, I want to explain about again SMS. Use mask, maintain social distance and wash your hands regularly per day 5-6 times. Okay, for your better health, you should follow this one. Okay, now, so in the previous session, what we learned? Number lines, rational numbers on the number line we learn, and inserting of a rational number between any two rational numbers, that we learn, and decimal form, okay, and changing of p by q form. Now, in exercise 1.1, 8 sum I given, no, 1 sum I will explain, once again I will recall that one, 0.5, 0.8 sum first bit I am saying, 8 sum. First bit 0.5 bar. This you have to change into a p by q form. How can you change into a p by q form? First, 0.5 is nothing but 0.5555, so on. No? On which number bar will be there? That means the number is repeating number of times. The number is repeating number of times. So 5 is repeating, that's why 555, so on. Now, let x is equal to 0.555, so on, call it as equation 1. Okay, now, what is the periodicity? Periodicity you should write must. Periodicity. What is periodicity? On which number bar is there? How many numbers bar is there? This line is called bar. So, on 5, only 5 means only one number it is having bar. So, the periodicity is equal to 1. So, if the periodicity is 1, you have to multiply 10 both sides. You have to multiply the 10 by both sides. So, if periodicity is 2, you have to multiply by 100 both sides. If periodicity is 3, you have to multiply by 1000 both sides. Now here periodicity is 1. So multiply by 10 on both sides. Understood? Then what you will get? 10 into x is equal to 10 into 0.555, so on. You have to multiply by 10, equation 1. You have to multiply by 10, by equation 1 on both sides. Now, if you multiply 10 into x, what you will get? 10x. 10x is equal to, if you multiply 10 into 0.555, so on. So, where the decimal will come? 10. When you multiply the decimal, you are multiplying by 10 means the decimal will move only one place forward. If you multiply by 100, the decimal will move 2 places forward. So here we are multiplying by 10. So the decimal will move only one place. So what you will get now? 5 point. This decimal will come here now. So 5.5555, so on. Call it as equation 2. Now understood? So first you have to write the periodicity. According to the periodicity, you have to multiply. The periodicity is 10. You have to multiply by, periodicity is 1. You have to multiply by 10. If periodicity is 2, you have to multiply by 100. Then, like that, if you multiply, you will get equation 2. Then, after getting 1 and 2, what you have to do? Equation 1 should be subtracted from equation 2. So, subtract equation 1 from equation 2. Okay? So, which one you will write first? Equation 1 we have to write first. So, what is equation 1? Equation 2 you have to write first. That is 10x is equal to 5.555, so on. This is equation 2. Now, what is equation 1? X is equal to, this is equation 1. X is equal to 0.555, so on. So, 0.555, so on. See here, you have to observe one thing. your decimal is there. Down you have to put the same decimal, means before the number here. Now subtract from here. So 5 all you are getting zeros. No need to write the zero. Now 5 minus 0. What you will get? 5 is equal to 10x minus x, 9x. So it implies x is equal to 5 by 9. So what is the answer? X is equal to 5 by 9. So decimal means this is a non-terminating repeating decimal. So non-terminating repeating decimal, the decimal form you are changing into a p by q form. Understood? Okay, this only homework I given. So like this you have to see in the third bit. 0.36 bar. 36 bar means the periodicity is 2 now. So periodicity 2 means you have to multiply by 100. So when you multiply by 100, the decimal should move 2 places forward. So like that you can do. Now, ninth one, without actual dividing, find out which of the following are terminating decimals. See, for example, 225 by 1000, like this I given. So, without doing division, I want the decimal form. So, how can you do? That I will explain. With the division means 225, you will divide and you will see the answer. But without division, I want the answer. So, how we can do? Before going there, I want to say this one. 2 to the power m and 5 to the power n. If the denominator is having in the form of the factors, the prime factor should be in the form of 2 to the power m and 5 to the power n, then the fraction is a terminating decimal. What is mean by terminating? Means you are getting 0 as the remainder. That is called terminating decimal. So, 1 sum first way, 9 sum first way, 3 by 25 is there. So, 3 by 25. So, without doing the division, you should say that 3 by 5 is a terminating or non-terminating. So, you see, 3 by 25, what I said, take the denominator. So, this 25, what are the prime factorization of 25? You can write this 25 is in 5 square, means 5 into 5, no? So, 5 to the power n means the base should be 5 or the base should be 2. In the prime factorization it is there, means the fraction is a terminating fraction. Either this one or this one or both. But along with this, for example, 35 by 16 is there. 30 by 16, no? And one more number. Okay. Base 2, no. 17 by 35 is a terminating or non-terminating? See this 35, what is the prime factorization of 35? 7 5 is 35. See, what is the power of 5? 1. So the base 5 is there, but along with this 7 also is, it is having. So, it is not a terminating decimal. It is a non-terminating decimal. Like that you have to see. In this 2 to the power 2 or 5, anyone should be, have the base, then the whole fraction become the terminating. Along with this 2, one more is there. Another number is as the base. No, that is not a terminating decimal. So, 3 by 25 is a terminating decimal. Terminating decimal means if you divide 3 by 25, you are getting remainder as 0. Okay, now second way, 11 by 18. Say 11 by 18 is a terminating or non-terminating? Take 18. What is the prime factorization of 18? 2 9s are 3 3s are. So, what the prime factors you are getting now? 9, 11 by square. This is the prime product, no? So 2 is the base is there, but along with the 2, 3 also base, 3 square. 3 is also having the base here. So it should be in the form of 2 to the power n and 5 to the power n. Otherwise only 2 to the power n or only 5 to the power n. But along with that, other numbers also having as the base, the fraction is not a terminating decimal. So now 11 by 18 is a terminating decimal? No. So it is a non-terminating decimal. Like that 13 by 20, 13 by 20 is a terminating or non-terminating? 20. Take LCM. 2 table. 2 tens are. Again 2 fives are. 5 ones are. Now this how can you write? Ma? 2 square into 5. Means 2 base is there. Along with that 5 also base is there. That's why it is a terminating. Now 41 by 42. 41 by 42 is a terminating or non-terminating? 42 LCM you have to see. 42. 2 21s are 3 7s are. See 2 into 3 into 7. Along with 2, 3 and 7 also there. That's why it is not a terminating decimal. Okay? Understood? Now this you have to complete. Now if any irrational number is given, for example, what is the irrational numbers, ma? Which does not have the perfect square root. For example, root 2, root 2, root 3, root 5, root 7. These are the irrational numbers. Okay, now that irrational number, you have to find the decimal values. So let us find the value of root 2 by long division method. Root 2 by long division method. Okay, root 2 is an irrational number. This, for this irrational number, we have to find the decimal values by using long division. So how can you find? First, here 2 you write. Okay, ma? 2 you write here. And after that, what you will write? Put decimal and add zeros. First, minimum 8 zeros will take. Why? Because each page, 8 zeros means 4 pages you have to take. Each number on each page you put bar. Here also bar. Okay? 1 page, 2 pages, 3 pages, 4 pages. Why we have to take 4 pages? Means up to 3 decimals you have to find the answer. Up to 3 decimals means you should move the 4th decimal, then you have to conclude it. So we have to take the 4 pair of zeros. After that you have to draw the line like this, and horizontal up also you have to draw the line like this. Now see the first one. What is the first one? 2. Okay, 2 is there. So what the number we are taking here, same number you should take here also and multiply. 2 will come in which table? 1 table and 2 table. 1 table, 1 2s are 2 you get. Otherwise 2 1s are 2 you get. But what I said, what the number here you are taking, you have to take here also same number I said, no? So it is not possible. So 1 1s are only you can take. 1 1s are 1. 1 1s are 2 you won't get, no? 1 1s are 1. So here 1 you have to take, here also you have to take 1. Now 1 1s are 1. Now subtract. 2 minus 1, 1. Here decimal is there, no? Put the decimal here. What the number we are taking here, here you have to write down, put plus sign and draw the line. Add these two numbers, 1 plus 1, 2. But these two don't write down here. Side you have to write 2. Why we have to write side, I will say here afterwards. Now here 2 zeros are there. Generally in the division method what we will do, no? Only one number we will draw, we will carry down now. But here 2 zeros means 1 pair of 0 you have to take down. Now it become 100. Now here 100. 2 here is there already, 2 is there. Okay. Here what the number you are taking, same number here also you should take. Suppose I want to take here 4. So here also I have to take 4. 96. It is less than 100. Okay, I want to try to take 5 also. 2 is common only. Don't change 2. Why? Because here we got 2. No. So that 2 you have to keep like that only. Now take 5. 5 5s are 25. 2 5 2s are 10. 12. Can I take 125? No, no. It is more than 100. So I want to take only 96. So what number I should take? 4. Here I have to write 4. Here also I have to write 4. Now understood why I didn't wrote down of that one? Side why I wrote? Because what the product we are taking, that we have to write here. That's why. Now 24 4s are 96. Now minus 100 minus 96, 4. Now again draw 2 zeros here. Now it becomes 400. Now here what we have to do? Again put plus. What 4 you wrote now? Here down you have to write. Now 24 plus 4, 28 it becomes. Now for 400 you have to say. Now 28 you have to take as it is. Okay. 400 you have to get means here what the number you want to take. Suppose I want to take 2 here. Now it becomes 282 into 2. 282 into 2. Now multiply. 2 2s are 4. 2 8s are 16. 2 2s are 4, 1, 5. 564. It is more than 400. So what number? What number I can take now? Only 1. 1. So 281 only I get. Now here I have to take 1. Here also I have to take 1. Now 281. Now again subtract it. Here 0 means you can take carry from your 10. 10 minus 1, 9. Here actually 10, but we are taking carry, so that's why it becomes 9 now. 9 minus 8, 1. Actually carry will goes from that number only. So here 3 you are having. 3 minus 2, 1. 119 you got. Now down again 2 zeros. Here what we have to do? 1 you have to add now. Plus 1. Now 281 plus 1, 282. Now 11,900 is there. Now 282 you have to take, and by which number if you multiply you are getting this one? Suppose I want to take 5. By 5 I want to multiply. I will see whether I will get less than or equal. Now 5 5s are 25, 2, 5 2s are 10, 12, 1, 5 8s are 40, 1, 41, 4, 5 2s are 10, 4, 14, 14,000. I am getting it is more than no. So here 11,000 only. So 3 I want to try. 3, 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6, 3 8s are 24, 3 2s are 6, 8. 9, 6, 24, 2 carry, 6 to 8. Now 8,000. It is very less. Again, we will see 4. 4, 4 is a 16. 4, 4 is a 16. 4, 2 is a 8, 1, 9. 4, 8 is a 32, 1. No, 1 not there, no. 4, 8 is a 32, 3. 4, 2 is a 8, 3, 11. It is sufficient, no? 11,900 here. We got 11,296. So 11,296, which table? 4, 4, 4. Now subtract. 10 minus 6, 4, here 9, 9 minus 9, 0, here 8, 8 minus 2, how much more? 6. Now here plus 4 you have to add. Now 2,824 plus 4, 2,828. Now carry down last pair of 0. So how much you got? 60,400. Now what is our number? 2828. So 2828 means 60,000. If you suppose if you multiply by 2, you see how much will be. 2 2 is a 4, 2 8 is a 16, 1, 2 2 is a 4, 1, 5, 2 8 is a 16, 1, 2 2 is a 4, 1, 5. How much? 56,000. Yes, it is. Less than that one, no? So, you can take that 2. That is 56,564. Now subtract. 10 minus 4, 6. 9 minus 6, 3. Here 13. 13 minus 5, 8. Here again 9. 9 minus 6, 3. Okay? Here 2 we wrote already. Now here add 2. Okay. Now what the answer I got? Here in the question he is asking up to 3 decimal place. So but what up to 4 decimals I got 1.4142. But 3 decimal place you have to conclude. That is, you have to see the 4th decimal place. It is 5 or more than 5. You can add the previous number 1. But it is less than 5. Up to here only you have to take. No need to add. So 1.414. Therefore, the 2 root 2 is 1.414. Now understood, children? So one homework I want to give. You have to find root 3 value by using long division method up to 3 decimal places. By long division method. Okay? By long division method, you have to find root 3 value up to 3 decimal places. Okay, thank you children. Have a nice day.